الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earth and the heavens, the King of the Day of Judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluh, wa safiyuhu min khalqihi wa khaliluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We bear witness that there is no Lord but the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that indeed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. I remind myself and remind you to be pious, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that you do. For He Azza wa Jal says and orders us in so many places in the Quran when He says, Azza wa Jal, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu attaqullaha haqqa tuqatih, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Oh, who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and die in no way except in the way of Islam, and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Oh, you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow, and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He Azza wa Jal knows best what you do. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our day a blessed day, inshallah, to forgive our sins, to guide our steps, and to keep us steadfast. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the fundamental belief that we have in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the concept of tawheed, which is the basis of the construct of everything that we do, is one that has to be invoked always in our lives. And every day we wake up, we should look for ways for us to live a life in accordance with the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of these foundations of tawheed is what we call tawheed al-rububiyyah, knowing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high is the creator and the sustainer of the earth and the heavens, that our livelihood is dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, the other aspects of it, tawheed al-uluhiyyah, which is to worship no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has its place as well. And the tawheed of al-asma and sifat also has the implication. But one of the things we have to do every single day is to look for ways to reaffirm our belief and our affirmation that there is no Lord but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is in the avenues of our livelihood that we should do this. And one of the things that revisits with us all the time, and we need to cultivate our belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through its applications, is the matter of rizq, the matter of livelihood, the matter of sustenance in one's life. One of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ar-Razzaq, which also is the other way of reaffirming our tawheed by understanding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and applying their implications in our lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high says, يا أيها الناس اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم هل من خالق غير الله يرزقكم في من السماء والأرض لا إله إلا هو فأنا تؤفكون. O people, remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. Is there a Lord other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high who provides for you in the earth and in the heavens? Indeed, there is no Lord but Allah. How do you fare? This affirmation is something that is done every morning for everything that you do. When you wake up in the morning, from the minute you open your eyes and you say, Asbahna wa asbah al mulku lillah, walhamdulillahi la sharika lah, la ilaha illa huwa wa ilayhi nushur. You reaffirm, we have awakened, and we have awakened where the kingdom is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in so many places in the Quran explains to us, Azza wa Jalla, and orders us to understand these constructs. And it's very important for us to bring it and shed life in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Dariyat says, Azza wa Jal, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, in Surah Al-Dariyat says, in yourselves, wouldn't you reflect? And then Azza wa Jal, he reaffirms a fact that must be a guiding light for us in everything that we do. It is indeed in heaven that your sustenance is there and that which you are promised. And then the Almighty Most High gives us the great swearing in. فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. The fact that you are in full comprehension, that you are actually uttering words, is the same level confirmation you have to understand that your rizq comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your livelihood and your sustenance, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is not a creature under this earth that is not sustained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows best what is for it. Everything is recorded. وَكَأَيِّن مِن دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Even if you look at a creature or another form of life and you think, how do they provide their sustenance? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers this Azza wa Jal to you. And he says, Allahu yarzuquha. And then he reminds you, wa iyyakum, and you too. For he, Azza wa Jal, is the provider. Now these we know. And these are the beliefs that we are all believing in, alhamdulillah. And it is the practice of these things in our lives that reminds us and sustains us in order for us to remain, inshallah, steadfast on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-Razzaq is the person who is not worried about the matters of this dunya. He knows wealth and facility is in his hands. It is to do more good with it. So he's not beholden to it. He's not a servant of it. من أصبح وهمه الدنيا فرق الله عليه ضيعته وجعل فقره بين عينيه وأتته الدنيا ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما قد كتب له ومن أصبح وهمه الآخرة جمع الله عليه ضيعته وجعل غناه بين عينيه وأتته الدنيا وهي راغمة. So these implications must have their effect in our lives. And we all know that we have to take the causes for which rizq comes to us. We have to work hard for it. We have to make sure that we are equipped and able as we depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get our rizq. But today I want to address other aspects of this action that we do every day that reminds us that this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just a practical application in our lives, but rather it's a belief system. Rather it's an iman that comes from the heart. Rather it's a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather it's an application of a divine guidance that's meant for all of humanity. And rather it is about work and hard work, as well as it is about believing and it is relating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Combining the spiritual and the material in the application of everything that we do is the right path to success in this life and in the hereafter. فَأَمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَظِلُّ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا يَشْقَى in this life. And so for us to cultivate this meaning in this matter of rizq, which touches every one of us, and it is something that every one of us encounters, I want to remind all of us, myself included, of 8 things. 4 of them are the matter of al-qalb, like the scholars say, أُمُورُ الْقُلُوبِ أو عِبَادَاتُ الْقُلُوبِ. And 4 of them are عِبَادَاتُ الْجَوَارِحِ. But they are not the simple action of just getting and working hard and obtaining rizq. And when we do this, we cultivate in our minds, how can we live our lives to the fullest in accordance with the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the life of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was having a hard time. A companion who's known, Abu Umam al-Bahili. He was in the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at an odd hour. It wasn't a salah time, and he was there sitting reflecting, praying. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked him, ما الذي أجلسك في المسجد في هذه الساعة؟ فقال رضي الله عنه يا رسول الله هموما أصابتني وديونا غلبتني أصابني الهم وغلبني الدين الذي هو هم الليل وذل النهار. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أعلمك كلمات إذا قلتهن أذهب الله همك وقضى دينك؟ قال بلى يا رسول الله. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم قل إذا أصبحت وأمسيت اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن، وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل، وأعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل، وأعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. فقال أبو أمامة رضي الله عنه فقلتهن فأذهب الله همي وقضى ديني. Now again, the mere recitation of the words was not the action that did this. But the fact that you know that your rizq comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that when you are in a hardship that may sound material and may sound something connected to efforts that you have to do in this life, for you to disconnect from the real source of rizq, and the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ, then you cannot move on in this life to thrive and to prosper and to be able to achieve the success that you want without reconnecting with the real source of power, with the real source of sustenance, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sustainer of the earth and the heavens. So these eight things are those that have to do with the qalb and the cultivation of the inner ibadah, like the scholars say, is taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wal-istighfar, wal-tawakkul, wal-shukr. And the four that have to do with things that you should do, and you may not realize that they are connected to your rizq, and you may not realize that they actually impact your rizq, are silatul rahm, al-infaq fi sabilillah azza wa jal, al-ihsanu ila al-du'afai wal-muhtajin, al-istiqamatu wa talab al-rizq bima yurdillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The eight things, four of them are related to ibadat that we can do within our hearts, and four are related to things that we should do. The first is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And hear me say what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Most High says in the Quran. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Sahih. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says those who take the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will find a way out for them. But then the Most High, what does he say? وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْتُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. So the rizq that comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is boundless. But it comes through the path of taqwa. And it comes through the path of taqwa irregardless or irrespective of anything else you do. So you cannot look just for, I will work 16 hours instead of 12 hours, or I'll work 12 hours instead of 8 hours so that I can increase my income or so that I can increase the sustenance of my life. This is all halal things. This is the things that we are required to do. But unless we infuse the meaning of what we say when we say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, in everything that we do, unless we do, we will elude success and we will not be able to do that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Most High asks of us. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنَوْا أَوْ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If the people of the villages believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and achieved taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open the blessings of the earth and the heavens upon them. The second one is that of istighfar. How many of us, if they had a hard time, if they felt that they are facing the struggles of this life, would think of the ibadah of istighfar? We do it in so many other ways. But in the matter of rizq, which consumes at least 8 hours a day from each of us, maybe more for many others who work two jobs and weekends and things like this, and we can't let our lives be taken away by the pressures and the difficulties of this dunya, but rather we must remain always connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we ascend from the chains of this life and we allow ourselves, inshallah, to remain connected with the source of guidance and the source of happiness, the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, من أكثر الاستغفار جعل الله من كل هم فرجا ومن كل ضيق مخرجا. Again, the constant ibadah of istighfar, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, repentance. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says also, ورزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. Rizq also is attained through the ibadah of istighfar. Nuh alayhi salam, when he was talking to his people, فَقُلْتِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلُ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلُ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلُ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. He is physically talking to his people. He says, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, for He is the forgiver. He will send the heavens upon you constant, and He will grant you wealth and children, and He will make gardens for you, and He will give you rivers. Was Nuh alayhi salam lying to his people? Was he promising something that will not happen? This is the book and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hud alayhi salam, when he was talking to his people, he says, Ya qawm istaghfiru rabbakum, thumma tubu ilayh, yursilu as-samaa'a alaykum midrara, wa yazidkum quwwatan ila quwwatikum, wa la tatawallaw mujrimin. Hud making the same promise to his people. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. Return and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will grant you the blessings of the heavens. And He will increase your might, that which you have, more might to your might. And on and on and on. So taqwa Allah and al-istighfar. The third one is, as we all know, the tawakkul, the dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is something that we constantly remind ourselves, that our dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is attained when we do everything that we can, while at all times knowing where the real source of rizq is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and eventually submitting and knowing that we have exhausted everything that we know, that then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us with His blessings. نعم أجر العاملين الذين صبروا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون. Those who are acting patient and indeed depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإذا عزمت فتوكل على الله. توكل on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Umar, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, that if you truly depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصة وتعود بطانة. If you truly achieve and attain the real meaning of dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you, will sustain you. The same way the birds wake up in the morning with an empty stomach and they come at the end of the day with a full stomach. They don't know where they're going to get their food from, but they go and travel and do everything they can, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed takes care of them. Indeed, as we said, it is tied to the effort. هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه. So the ibadah of tawakkul must be something that we always cultivate every morning, every day, when we are spending these long hours in attaining our rizq. Fourthly, that of shukr. Being always thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that the more the servant is grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thanking the Almighty Azza wa Jal for the blessings, the more Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him with it. Shukr is also by action. وَقُلْ عَمَلُوا آلَ دَوُودَ شُكْرًا. By action you show your shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu yaqul, مَا أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عَبْدٍ نِعْمَةً فَقَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ إلا كان الذي أعطاه أفضل مما أخذ. That if you are constantly in the ibadah of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has given you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you even most high, the most generous subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are the four of the matters of qalb, and start cultivating them and making them part of your daily routine. Think about them as you do everything that you do. Taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الاستغفار, توكل على الله سبحانه وتعالى, and شكر الله سبحانه وتعالى, and thanking Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and being grateful. The other four, that is actions that you take, that sometimes you may not attribute to the same concept of attaining rizq. You may not piece them into doing that which will also bless your sustenance and bless your ability to provide for your family. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us that connecting with your kin and mending the fences between those that you know, silatul rahm. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم من سره أن يبسط له في رزقه وأن ينسأ له في أجله فليصل رحمه. He who wants to see the broadening and the increase of his rizq, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us, go and remedy and connect with your kin. إن أعجل الطاعة ثوابا صلة الرحم. حتى أن أهل البيت لا يكونون فجرة فتنمو أموالهم ويكثر عددهم إذا تواصلوا. It's a sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who sustain people around them, those who reach out to their families, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them with means and with the ability to grow more. تعلموا من أنسابكم ما تصلون به أرحامكم فإن صلة الرحم محبة في الأهل ومثراة في المال ومنساءة في العمر. The Prophet ﷺ tells us, increase those relationships that you have with your kinship, for indeed it will increase the love and the happiness between families, but it will also increase your wealth and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide for you. And of course, as we all know, when you are connecting with your kin, it's not just rewarding the like with something back. Salatul Rahim does not mean that if somebody asks about you, you call back and ask for them. Or if somebody helps you, you do the same. That's a requirement, because it's what you should do in order to answer back to somebody who has done some good for you. But the real understanding of kinship and reconnecting with your kinship is when you do it to those who have not done it to you, or to those who have disconnected from you, and you take it upon yourself to make sure that you do your godly responsibility by reaching out to them. ليس الواصل بالمكافئ ولكن الواصل من إذا قطع رحمه أو رحمه وصلها. The sixth one is to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that may sound like an antithesis to the accumulation of wealth. How can you spend it all and think that this is the way that you increase it more? One of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Abdul Rahman ibn Auf. He was a very wealthy, actually, companion. He is the man that when we are reading the books of Sirah, you know, when he came to Medina and he did not have anything as a muhajir. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the relationships between al-muhajirin and al-ansar. And the Ansari wanted to give him things. He told him, don't give me anything. Just show me where the market is and let me take care of my matters. And he did. And he was known to be one of the wealthiest of the companions. He used to say, رضي الله عنه وأرضاه, and he was one of the عشر المبشرين بالجنة. And he was one of the six that Umar رضي الله عنه has picked to be a Khalifa after him. He says, عودني الله تعالى عادة وعودته عز وجل عادة فلا أقطع عادتي مع الله فيقطع عادته معي سبحانه وتعالى. He says that I have established a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a habit. And I want to continue that habit, for I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high returns it in return. And I will never discontinue this habit, because then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will discontinue it with me. And he was referring on how every time his rizq increases, every time his wealth increases, he would spend even more for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he sees the return. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in so many places in the Quran, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ. Anything you spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace and will return it back to you. And indeed, he is the best of givers. الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Indeed, shaitan promises you poverty and misery, and he tells you to do that which is not righteous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you forgiveness, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you more giving from him, azza wa jal. Indeed, Allah is wide and most knowledgeable. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also in the hadith, when he swears, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that, talata uqsimu alayhin, three things I will swear upon them, one of them, ma naqasa malun min sadaqa. So the idea of allowing ourselves to cultivate this ibadah of giving for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should honor and we should work very hard to do it. Indeed, those who are removed from the illness of holding back are indeed those who are the successful one. وَمَن يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. That's one of the ills that all of us must work very hard to eliminate, which is to hold back when it comes to giving for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, it is one of the things that allows for the breadth of the rizq that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestows upon you. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن السخي قريب من الله قريب من الناس قريب من الجنة بعيد عن النار وإن البخيل بعيد عن الله بعيدا عن الناس بعيدا عن الجنة أو من الجنة قريبا من النار. Indeed, it's one of the ways to cultivate your rizq. The seventh one is to give to others. Not just to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but to take care of the matters of others. Be there when people need you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return it upon you barakah that would allow inshallah for more to come your way. من كان في حاجة أخيه كان الله في حاجته. He who helps his brother to take care of a matter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of his matters. وَمَنْ يَسَّرَ عَلَى مُعَسِّرٍ يَسَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. And he who makes it easy for somebody who is in hardship, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for him, not just in the hereafter, also in this dunya. يَا أَسْمَاء أَنْفِقِي يُنْفِقِ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. The last one is that which is the steadfastness on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to do that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the matter of rizq. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن روح القدس أو القدس نفث في روعي أن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستكمل رزقها فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب ولا يحملنكم استبطاء الرزق أن تطلبوه بمعاصي الله عز وجل فإن الله لا يدرك ما عنده إلا بطاعته. The Prophet ﷺ says, Jibreel alayhi salam told me that there is not a soul that will die until all of its rizq that has been prescribed for it by the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala will be given to it or will be given to him or her. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do the best that you can in order to get that share that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, has allocated for you. And do not think that the fact that it has not come when you asked for it And do not allow that to take you to do the wrong things in order to get your rizq. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high gives us which can only be obtained through his worship subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so for us to make sure that we are eating the halal and we are enjoying the halal and we are looking out for ourselves to make sure that everything that we do is indeed through the blessings and through the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى وَاتَّقَى وَصَدَّقَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْيُسْرَى وَأَمَّا مَنْ بَخِلَ وَاسْتَغْنَى وَكَدَّبَ بِالْحُسْنَى فَسَنُيَسِّرُهُ لِلْعُسْرَى وَمَا يُغْنِي عَنْهُ مَالُهُ إِذَا تَرَدَّى. Indeed, the rizq is a path through which, inshallah, we can cultivate the meaning of tawheed in our lives. But remember, it is not just the hard hours or the long hours that will bring it to you. It is indeed cultivating all these meanings, whether it's taqwa or istighfar or tawakkul or shukr or salat al-rahm or infaq fi sabilillah or helping the poor or gaining your rizq through the best of means. These are the things that will help, inshallah, all of us to cultivate the healthiest, inshallah, of families and the healthiest of pathways. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enlighten our hearts, to keep us steadfast, to forgive our sins, and to give us, inshallah, from His mighty and very wide rizq. Allahumma ameen, Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hada wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiru innahu ghafur rahim. Astaghfirullah. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه الصلاة والسلام على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear respected brothers and sisters, every day, every week, we cannot but remember our brothers and sisters all over the place. In our ummah, back home, and here, and everywhere. And even though we may talk on topics that may be relevant to us and important to us, and it will help us, inshallah, be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot but remember the struggles and the strife that is engulfing so many parts of our ummah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy, inshallah, for our brothers and sisters in Syria who have seen so much suffering, who have had so much killing and so much hardship. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them, inshallah, the blessings of peace and prosperity and to stop the evil and the injustice that's beholding them. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in Egypt, for they have seen a regression, injustice, and in human rights, and the criminality of the military today is going beyond any level of expectation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help our brothers and sisters in Central Africa, where Muslims are killed only for saying La ilaha illallah. Our brothers and sisters in Burma, where they are being burned, where the world does not even know that this tragedy exists. And our brothers and sisters in Palestine, where yes, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Bayt al-Maqdis and the land of the prophets is still being dirtied and overwhelmed by the injustice that engulfs it. In everywhere, in Libya, in Tunisia, in Algeria, in Kashmir, in Sudan, in Iraq, in Afghanistan, everywhere where there is injustice, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to absolve us from this injustice and to allow us to be part and parcel of those who will, inshallah, change the course of history and be able to change from their position of responsibility here as American Muslims who can, inshallah, make a difference. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and guide us. Allahumma afu anna wa gfir lana wa arhamna. Anta maulana fansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdibina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Wa zakkiha maulaya anta khayru man zakkaha. Anta waliyaha wa maulaha. Ibadallah. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعدكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وقوموا إلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة